Good day students, and welcome back once again for your geography class. So in this video we will be doing revision of all the portion that you have for your geography paper for the second unit test. So we will begin with the first chapter which you have, that is precipitation. So we are aware that as the atmospheric conditions change, we see changes in the forms of condensation. Okay, so when water falls in the solid or liquid, state from the clouds to the ground, we call it as precipitation. Now the major forms of precipitation are snow, hailstones, rainfall. Let us know more about these in detail. We know that snow falls when all the air between the cloud and earth's surface is below freezing. Hail. The balls of ice that fall from clouds and can even put dents in cars are known as hail. So hail is created in thunderstorms, clouds. Now water droplets form in the clouds and they get pushed upward where temperatures are colder. These droplets freeze and they form hailstones. The hailstones grow as more and more water droplets freeze onto them, and eventually they fall to the ground. Hailstones can be very destructive. Rainfall. The temperature of the air with water vapor reduces when it goes higher. Condensation of the vapor occurs. Clouds form when the condensed water droplets and dust particles accumulate. The water droplets increase in size. When they cannot float in the air anymore because of their weight, they come down as rainfall. Now we have studied mainly three major types of rainfall: conventional rainfall, orographic rainfall, and cyclonic rainfall. Conventional rainfall occurs when sun heats the land and the air above. Warm air rises, cools and condenses, forming clouds. Thus rain occurs. Orographic rainfall occurs due to obstruction of mountains. The warm, moist air is forced to rise over high areas. Here, the air cools and condenses, forming clouds. And due to the obstruction of the mountains, it rains. So the windward side of the mountain gets more rain and the leeward side of the mountain gets less rainfall. The leeward side of the mountain is also identified as the rain shadow area. Cyclonic rainfall. Cyclonic rainfall occurs when air from the surrounding region comes towards the center of the cyclone and starts moving upwards. As it rises, the temperature of air reduces and condensation occurs and rainfall takes place. The factors that affect the amount of rainfall in a region are the amount of vapor in the atmosphere, air pressure, temperature, the topography of the place, also the latitudinal position of a place. The instrument that is used to measure rainfall is called as the rain gauge. Fog, dew and frost. When condensation or solidification of water vapor in the atmosphere occurs near the earth's surface, then we get fog, dew and frost. So the temperature of the layers of the air near the surface of the earth reduces, and as the temperature reduces, water vapor condenses. In this process, vapor turns into microscopic water particles and they float in the air. When the density of these droplets in the air increases, fog occurs. When moisture-laden air near the earth's surface comes into contact with very cold objects, condensation of the vapor takes place. They turn into very small water droplets, and these water droplets stick to the surface of the cold objects, which we called as dew. And if the temperature of the air is less than 0 degrees Celsius, that is below the freezing point, then the water droplets that are stuck to the surface of the cold objects freeze. This frozen water droplet is called as frost. And dew and frost occur on a large scale in winters. So what are the effects of precipitation? There are various positive effects as well as negative effects of precipitation. So due to precipitation, we get potable water, that is drinking water. Floods may also occur due to excessive rainfall. Then lack of precipitation can lead to droughts, thus causing shortfall of food, which can lead the farmers into grave situations and thus affecting the country's economy. Also, untimely rainfall can cause damage to the crops. Dense fog reduces visibility, and this can affect the transportation system like airways, waterways, roadways, etc. Frost too is harmful to the crops, and hailstones can also cause massive destruction to the crops. Acid rains. Now, because of air pollution in industrial areas, various gases get mixed in the air, because of which different acids are created when the water vapor in the air reacts chemically with these gases. Some of the gases are nitric acid, sulfuric acid, etc. Now, precipitation of water with dissolved acids reach the ground, and such kind of rainfall is called as acid rain. Acid rainfall is very harmful to both living as well as non-living objects. So with this, we have finished revising the first chapter which you have for unit test, that is precipitation. Now let us continue to the next chapter. Properties of seawater. So mainly we studied in this chapter three properties of seawater, that is temperature, salinity and density. So we are aware that temperature is a major property of seawater. The surface temperature of the seawater decreases from the equatorial areas towards the poles. The intensity of sun rays decreases with increasing depth. So temperature decreases up to 2000 meters depth, and after 2000 meters depth, the temperature of the seawater is uniform everywhere on the earth. It is about 4 degrees Celsius everywhere from the equatorial areas or equatorial regions to the polar areas. But there is also difference in open seas and landlocked seas. We have already studied what are landlocked seas. Landlocked seas are seas which are covered by land on all the four sides. So as the salinity of landlocked seas is more, the temperature of the landlocked seas is also higher than the open seas. Let us revise the next property of seawater, that is salinity. Okay, so we know what is the meaning of salinity. Salinity is the presence of salt. Okay, so there are three main things about salinity of water that we must remember. First thing is, in seas where the rate of evaporation is high, then the supply of fresh water, the salinity is high. In seas where the supply of fresh water exceeds the rate of evaporation, salinity is low. And salinity is not affected much in seas where both the supply of fresh water and evaporation of water is low. We had seen this through an experiment. Okay, so remember, high rate of evaporation plus low supply of fresh water gives you high salinity. Low rate of evaporation and high supply of fresh water gives you low salinity. The next property of seawater is density. The temperature and salinity are the two properties of seawater that control the density of seawater. So if temperature reduces, density of water also increases. Therefore, you will see that cold water is denser than hot water. The salinity of seawater. If the salinity of water is high, then the density of water also increases. Now, after around 1000 meters depth, you will see that there is no change in the temperature, salinity and density of the sea water, because at greater depths, the winds, sun rays and ocean currents do not affect these three properties. The ocean currents that are generated because of difference in properties of seawater also act as temperature controllers at the global level. So with this, we have revised in short properties of seawater.